elected mayors, district chairpersons, and councillors of Southern Province, the administrative staff of the Ministry of Local Government, local councils, the farm sector, functionaries, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Today is a great day in local governance. It is a day as enshrined in Section 8 of the Local Government Act of 2022, newly elected mayors, district chairpersons, and councillors will subscribe to the oath. It's therefore a mandatory and very important ceremony as far as the governance architecture is concerned. So we want to welcome you all, we want to appreciate you, and as Minister of Local Government and Community Affairs, I've got a few words of admonition, just a few, because today's event is mainly centered at OT. I want to particularly thank the Honourable Vice President in his role as Chairman of the Interministerial Council, agreeing to officiate this occasion. Local councils, starting in Sierra Leone in 2004, the current local councils. From that day, Bokuti don't happen in local governance. When government they want to achieve that 10 day after the war done, now for certain people they were there and in local areas, for let them participate in decision making, for teaching them where they affect them, where they put themselves directly within the localities. Since that time, initially, we began local councils, and this year term, 19 local councils at that time. This year term, we add a few, now we get 22 local councils nationwide. Where we will go around with His Excellency, the President, retired President Julius Maada Bio. A lot of strength will happen. Wearing councils that they tell me what they're going to do in the localities. And it actually shows that local governance don't come in one way, even though arms for them to come on. What is important for local governance? Now collaboration, partnership. We need to advocate so that the thing that we want for community people will be able to achieve. In fact, we now want to be elect as councillors. We now will be the bridge between our communities, the wards that we represent, and also down our district that we represent, and the council. So that the thing that really happen in the community, they take a look at the party for the council ways of dealing with that. We now, as councillors, we now also get a role for level of monitor and level of supervise various projects with the calm and our locality. We talk to the monitor, we want what we call structured monitoring. And we're talking about structural money over the ground over the decisive local for carbon interview. because we will not be the one that complain and blame. We want when it comes to what we can say, you know, this project will go on. We want the focus to visit. For let me find out what this project will do, how the project will go, for let me find the report back and council. Then, when I get home, for mobilizing that project, for community projects, very important, politicians, when I get for mobilizing that people, they have to have a locality, when I inform them, what is going to happen in our government and what is council.
Very, very important
to let us know. What stage is it? Canceling a job, not a full-time job. Somebody will work, will give few hours to the local council. Very important for them to stress that, because the worst case is what you will get is that you will get salary. Stress the importance of relationships, building relationships. The new local government act with Parliament they just passed last year. It talked to several issues of relationship. How we can work together,
make sure
the governance is effective and the work are doing. The relationship between the councillor and the member of government.
Very important.
Not a competition. Now, one for our value to the other one. The relationship between the councillor and the MP is very strategic, very important. The fact that that made inside the new local government act will bring the MPs in. For letting them come, letting them participate inside council. Although they're going to vote. Because what did they happen at the locality is then said we'll take out the caravan of parliament for letting go discuss at me. The relationship between the council and the provincial peace. That is a very important inside this act. We get the resident minister, we get a critical role in regional coordination so that the diverse sectors that will be functional. We will find a very important say that is important for what we bring that coming. So when the resident minister can at the council, we don't mean for certain interference, but support. Now if the council can be so that then when the will are the four sectors, whoever listen to council, together with the chairpersons and the mayors, they will turn out together for what they push, for what they listen. The relationship between councillors, council leadership, and the core staff. We need to mention that again. The core staff, the councils, the technical staff, waiting for Savona. For make sure say, we will work easier. Then, if we will work for the easier, that they get for Cairo, especially the one that we don't just start. Important for them to get good relationship. Important as well, the councillors and the leadership, whether the mayor and the chairpersons, for that relationship be cordial for effective functioning of the locality council. Important also for that relationship be smooth and cordial between the councillors of the district council and the chiefdom councils. The chiefdom councils are first building block of governance. Important for another relationship day. In fact, I am able to expand the number of chiefs when they participate inside councils, then inside the local government staff. Development partners, important as well. For me, we are as councillors, including the leadership, to let them get a good relationship, but also for proving to the development partners, especially the one they want projects in the way, for say yes, what you might decide to book, now we are to do. What you refer to as accountability. And we are going to be very transparent in our activities. Anything that happens in the local council, we expect someone from the publisher, so that the public will understand what you want to do. I want to also inform you for say we got something, a committee, where the honorable vice president and the chair that committee, they will call it a ministerial committee for local government. And the highest body, where they listen to any concerns they will get, any disputes, where will happen between either council and council, council and the ministry, council and other ministries or other diverse sectors. Because this committee are all the ministers, they will perform their functions. The decision at this committee for discussing commandments. The essence here, and for them to all work together, for them to keep it and keep it in centralization, and for them to make sure, see, you know, people that receive the services, we will now be promised this, we will now deliver. On that note, I want to congratulate you on all. We as a ministry, the committee say, we are available all the time through our various structures to work with you to ensure, say, what you got members here, what you want to for achieve, we all work together for our achievement. Thank you very much. Thank you.
The council is supposed to clap. This time only the minister will actually explain to them the goodies and the things that we will never go through. That the orientation will not begin so. We will only continue now that the different councils. Thank you very much, honorable minister, the government, where the minister talk, they make sure say that we will talk about the putting money for talking about them. Other than for maintaining, say, Una service and service for the people, the expectation is not going to be too high. What you want now for making left your name in the hearts of people who don't go for serve and the council. Honorable Minister, thank you very much. Now we come to this very important role of the government. We will enter today and all of our system. We have been not getting the way we put today. If we get that list, we will put program, where people will name them. Number two, we will get one book where that the compressed version of the decentralization policy, we will tell you everything we want to know about decentralization and local government. Then the third thing we will give now, that our leaflet way, that they will put right, where the person will come for taking a true that name. Now that thing you will have for the watch for the talk after by the taking a true that name. So ladies and gentlemen, I have the privilege and honor to invite the permanent secretary of the Ministry of Local Government and Community Affairs, Mr. Timothy Lansana, for come for the court administration. Let us also know, please, the press team, where the time began for the court of the government there, because my council is the government for a camp the administer the court the procedure. So,
Thank you. you understand it. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the Bond District Council.
settle so that we will enjoy this occasion very well, please. My number is in Paris, so we have already got him.
Thank you.
can conscientiously discard my duties as a counselor. So help me God. Thank you, thank you. Thank you.
declare that I will bear the true faith and allegiance to the Republic of Sierra Leone and the Bowen City Council as my law established, and I will faithfully and conscientiously describe my duties as a councillor. To help me go. Thank you.
Then, what do you Today, a very important day, and it's our Delta region. Because 5 years ago, we have come to inaugurate the various councils at Namoyamba, Kujel, both the Dome, and the Stadium. We know the game of whom are councillors. Today, we will celebrate even in Kujel district, where we get 0 councillors. Today, Kujel get 10 women councillors to the population of the Kujel district.
We are all
as a place of development for my people. When you say human capital development, education, health, agriculture, women empowerment, youth empowerment, we have a big responsibility in our communities, in our council, in our city, to make sure say, the president vision, now we are the ambassador to translate and concretely to the development in the area of town. This year, His Excellency Dr. Tobin said, the time to go to the world, the big five. The big five, President Maradio said, see the world to feed himself. You forever plant, wear food, and eat before they plant. The Dr. Tobin said, because of that, the number one agenda in the next 5 years, that feeds the world. Food security, food security, food security. What is that doing? It means that the government right now, they can develop a roadmap how to support His Excellency to implement that vision. We are the councils there. We are the municipalities there. We are going to get big responsibility in that vision. How to help to translate that vision in a greater level. So that way, in the time, a lot of our position will accept. All the support for the town for agriculture, for farmers, let them get access to seed, let them get access to machines, let them get access to fertilizer. The council will have to play very, very big role. The other two, number 2 points, the job creation. In some area of the children, in some area we provide transportation for them. We only put over 10,787 teachers in this country. So what is that going to mean? It means that in the next couple of years, you will get more boy picking and girl picking in the university and higher education. They will get education. They will get skills. And as a government, we get a responsibility to make sure that we can work for it. Maybe the excellency say in the next 5 years, we want to create 500,000 jobs so that we employ them and we get the way they skills. And we want to learn what are the things that train with them. Then we get it. So the council, what I said, they will play a big role in job creation opportunities. Because they establish farms. We create farms, we employ people who can do business like this thing. We support them to do business like this thing. We create small businesses. Through that way, we will create employment. The third thing, we're very important for you. His Excellency will say, even if you increase money, even if you get the people around you, in the public service, the public administration, not get qualified people then, and they not get system in place, they not be able to deliver on the aspiration. So the third important thing that for the fund the public service, which means UNICEF chef, we get today as councillors, we will have the role, now the various councils and municipalities, we will get responsibility, for them we will make sure we will get a solid and functional administration. The Minister of Local Government, he just don't tell now about the importance of building relationship. This relationship is very, 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 very important. Why is it important? Because when we are elected officials there, we are the meet staff there, we are the build relationship with them. Secondly, we are just build relationship back with the power chiefs. So many times, we get challenges between councils, municipalities, and power chiefs. So the local power chief council then, we expect them for all the building relationship with them, make them everywhere, because we have all the mandate that will serve the people in our various communities. It's very, very, very important. Also, also for the mayor and the chairperson then. The final and being relationship with the councilor. The councilor is not over picking them. Not for the other man them. Now for being relationship to work with them. When you respect Posse, the person will work for you. When you don't find the Posse, it will work for you. This power is very rare. After 5 years, the power will go. So the relationship with the being and the make you able to do with the company, councilor and former councilor. So we advise the mayor and the chairperson them. Let them be in relationship with the administrative staff available for the council and the municipality. And also let them get very good relationship with their respective council of them. The other thing that is very important is that over the years, we don't encourage municipalities and councils them. For let them be very serious about revenue collection. Revenue collection, because you need money. Every council and municipality need money for function. For let them carry out what they will be mandated for carry out. So we have to take revenue collection very seriously. And it task all the councils them. And the municipalities then, when they go back, they for begin identify strategies they for put in place to improve revenue collection and manage the resources the government they give us. When I say President, Madam, you are talking to President. When you say the fight against corruption, and let you a counselor, you do something when you're supposed to do, you go against the law will bite you. So revenue collection and the management of financial resources is very, very important. So I encourage you on transparency, and I encourage you on big strategies for getting revenue, and able to spend that revenue that day. As chairman of the Interministerial Council and decentralization, I therefore move around the country. Anything work in every district, the first people they want to see that the mayor and the chairperson. After that, I again meeting with the councils. And I try to understand what people are do, the kind of people are that they do. This time around, we don't say we classify councils and municipalities. The councils, the way they do very well. The municipalities, the way they do very well. In terms of management, in terms of crisis management, in terms of revenue collection, in terms of working together as a team, we invite them and we give them the presidential and vice presidential award for the best councils in this country. And we will invite them to the event to all the councilmen. They will go to Freetown and we will have them that prize in front of His Excellency for telling them thank you for the good work we have done. And we will do it 2 times in the 5 years. We will do it after 2.5 years. We will move around, we do the classification. We give the prize them so that we motivate the other council them. In the next 2.5 years, let them say do extremely well. And I want to get back to this say, now government will consider, say all chairmen and chairpersons of the respective district councils, will say we will get an official regalia holder. So go we have a prayer, we will say to Tresma, we have to go to your official presence where to distinguish the chairmen and the deputy there from the rest of the mayor. So distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I want to use this opportunity for chairman Tanki and for congratulating her on behalf of His Excellency the President. The work don't begin. 5 years not a long time. When I don't begin work, I believe say starting today. Starting tomorrow, we are going to go back to the councils there and municipalities there and start the work. The big five, I don't already remind you now. Your responsibility as chairman of the Interministerial Committee, and for listening to her, and for supporting her, so that we are able to do our work. But the greater responsibility, it lies in her. So on that note, I want to thank you. I'm glad for Siuna, and as Siuna is shining, when I lay inside green and white, when I lay inside the colors of the famous, the one and only great SNDP particular. So, on behalf of the chairman, of the SNPP, I also want to congratulate you for your inauguration today. I wish you a good luck, and I want you to know for your receiving. Any district will come, and you will see the chairpersons, the mayors, and also the councillors. I want you to hear from you, what is the goal? How do you want the goal? What are the challenges? What are the opportunities? And what are the ideas that we want to get? What would I believe say government will support plan for implement? I want you to tell you, I want you to also consider seriously for improved conditions of service for mayors and councillors. And that day, when we complete the process, you have to know. Because councillors, that the most important politician there. Councillors, that the most valued politician there. Because they study the house of every voter. They study the problem of every voter.